We want to solve the given exponential equations by using like bases. This means you want to write both sides of the equation with the same base. If we can do this and the bases are the same, then the exponents must be equal to each other. In general, if a to the m is equal to a to the n, then m equals m. Again, if we have two exponential expressions equal to each other and the bases are the same, then the exponents must be equal. So looking at our first example, we have 27 raised to the power of x equals 2,187. Well, we can't write 2,187 with a base of 27, so what we have to do is write the left side of the equation using a different base. And to figure out how to do this, it's often helpful to take a look at the prime factorization. So 27 is equal to 9 times 3, and 9 is equal to 3 times 3. So 27 is equal to 3 factors of 3, which means we can write the left side of the equation as 3 to the third raised to the power of x equals, now we want to see if we can write 2,187 with a base of 3, which is not an easy task. Remember, since the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, so is this number, meaning since 2 plus 1 plus 8 plus 7 is equal to 18, which is divisible by 3, so is this number. So we know it's going to be 3 times something. If we needed to, we could use the calculator and take 2,187 and divide it by 3 to help us. It's equal to 729. 729 is also divisible by 3. Again, if we need to, we can use the calculator again. 729 divided by 3 is equal to 243. 2 plus 4 plus 6 equals 9, which is divisible by 3, so is this number. This is 3 times 81. 81 is equal to 9 times 9, and 9 is equal to 3 times 3. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 factors of 3. So we can write the right side as 3 raised to the power of 7. Now we do have a common base, but notice on the left side we have a power raised to a power, and the rule is that we can multiply these exponents. So we can write this as 3 raised to the power of 3x equals 3 to the 7th. In this form, since these are equal and the bases are the same, we know that 3x must equal 7. And this will allow us to solve for x. If 3x equals 7, we'll divide both sides by 3. And we have x equals 7/3. Let's take a look at our second example. Here we have 1/16 raised to the power of x is equal to 32. Again, our goal is to write the left side and the right side of the equation with the same base. Well, I know 16 is equal to 4 times 4, and 4 is equal to 2 times 2. So we could write this as 1 over 2 to the 4th raised to the power of x equals, now even though this is in fraction form, if we could write 32 with a base of 2, it would be helpful. And since 32 is equal to 2 times 16, and 16 is 2 to the 4th, 32 is equal to 2 to the 5th, one more factor of 2. Now we do want to have a common base of 2, so we need to change the form of this fraction here. Remember, we can move this up into the numerator, but it would change the sign of the exponent. So 1 over 2 to the 4th is equal to 2 raised to the power of negative 4. All this is raised to the power of x, and this is equal to 2 to the 5th. And now we do have a common base, but just like in the previous problem, we do have a power raised to a power here, so we need to multiply these exponents, so we're going to have 2 to the power of negative 4x equals 2 to the 5th. And now that these are equal and the bases are the same, we can conclude that negative 4x must equal 5, because the exponents must also be equal. So if negative 4x equals 5, divide both sides by negative 4. This simplifies to x, so we have x equals negative 5/4. Okay, we'll look at some more examples in the next video.